Morning, today is May 1st. We're going to do an update on the hydroponic garden system that I'm developing. This takes no electricity, unless you want to use it, of course. It's gravity fed. The plants use what they need, and then more fluid comes into the system. I've got a new system figured out. I'm waiting on some parts, then I'll show you how to build it. It's going to be extremely affordable. This is the dwarf beans I planted a couple weeks ago. They're getting ready to start growing big time. I see places where they're going to start branching out. They were good. I grew them last year. This is a pipe system that it's gravity fed. These three systems right here are all run off of one single tank. This is tank over here, 55 gallon. I mix up the nutrients, put it in there. And gravity flows. I have a float level in this tank right here that keeps the level of the fluids in these containers at a certain height. Therefore, the plants don't drown or they never need any fluid because it's always there for them. Same thing with this. You can have multiple heights just depending on where your nutrient tank is. Got some good lettuce growing. It was hard to get it because it was so hot. But we got one type that grows good in the summertime. We're going to start eating it for dinner now. Got some Swiss chard and kale started up. Some of the plants are good. Some of them's not. I'm still doing some tomato plants. And I've been removing plants out of this. I might be taking this one apart because I'm running out of room to put some garden, so I might use this space for some new tomato systems. I had a bunch of onions in here and I had so many it was drinking probably about 7 or 8 gallons of fluid a day. So I pulled the onions out. We cut up a bunch to eat and I had to get rid of the rest. Look at these big tomatoes on this thing. Let's see if I don't know if you can see them. This plant's not that old. We hadn't got any ripe ones from it yet, but it won't be long. Got jalapenos, Swiss chard, eggplant, kale, peppers, zucchinis, all growing, and it's all from this tank over here that's got some more plants on them starting up. This is Cherokee tomatoes. I planted these almost 2 weeks ago. I did a quick little video on it. This system here is something like what I'm doing. I haven't hooked this to a big tank yet. So I just keep a little bit of fluid in this 5 gallon bucket to go into the float tank to where the plant's keeping nutrients. I'm gonna have to start single stemming this. I haven't done anything to it. I've just been letting them sit there. They are starting to bloom. This system here, it's on wheels, it moves around, that way I have it short enough to where I can bring it in if we get a bad storm. The only thing about it is these wheels sink into the ground and they're pretty expensive. So I have figured out a way to where it won't sink in the ground. I'll be showing you on the new system. It's pretty impressive. I did this out of one bys and it's not that sturdy. So I will show you how I'm going to beef it up pretty soon. And this tomato plant right here is Brad Atomic Cherry. And this one here with the big tomatoes on it is Jubilee. I do believe it's going to be a yellow tomato. There's my jalapenos. Got a bunch on there, steadily flowering every day. And I got a bunch of herbs over here. My zucchini is still flowering. Every day I'm getting some new flowers. Got an orange one down there that didn't get pollinated, but I picked two of them yesterday. Got some eggplant starting off slowly, but they're producing pretty good. Long finger, white, Casper. This is a black goji berry plant right here. I've had the red ones before. I've never tasted the black ones. And here's another bush bean plant. They're starting to bloom. This right here is 50 Chinese long beans, asparagus beans, whatever you want to call it. I put 50 of them in here just to see what this bucket will do. I'm pretty sure it'll handle it. And this is what they call long zucchini. You're supposed to wait 24 hours after the bloom falls off, then you harvest it. So they get a little bit bigger than what you're supposed to do in the dirt. It's really impressive growing. I've already got 5 or 6 in the refrigerator right now. You pick them when they're small, or you let them grow into a winter squash. I'm going to let some grow when they get up here, or I'm going to let some of them grow real long. Do a winter squash. This thing right here is long enough to where it's going to be pretty neat looking. I put 3 plants in this unit. I probably got way too much in there, the way they're subdividing and everything. I planted these beans a month ago, and I've already got beans. It only takes 30 days when you grow pole beans for it to start producing. Pretty impressive, really. I'm going to let these beans grow up on the same system that I'm going to let this long squash grow on. And these beans are going to be good. I grew the same ones last year. I put some sweet potatoes in here. I got the vines going up the side. We're going to try it. They say they're really edible. And we're just going to see how good they are. And then my black cherry tomato plant, it has produced a bunch. We're picking like 15, 20 cherries every day. And this thing is still growing. It's a monster. I got like 3 more of these growing in the yard. So we will have a bunch of cherry tomatoes. They're excellent. This is my favorite, the black cherry. Let's see. I am starting up some plants. I got some more sweet potatoes started up. A couple more tomato plants. Well, actually more than that. Some 1-pound pinks. Some Bradley red. And then another red goji berry. I cut the top off of one plant. I'm starting to root it. Florida cranberry. And this is a star fruit tree. I planted some seeds and they all come up pretty impressive. I'm gonna be planting these out in the garden. And let's see, this is a 4th of July. I'm gonna be transplanting these. There's little tomatoes. Oh, and that's a white cell plant. That's an electric system. I am going to be pulling up some of these tomato plants pretty soon. I'm just now starting to get more sunlight here. As you can see, the sun is coming up. Whoops, right there. And then it goes over this way. It's right on the edge of these trees. Pretty soon we'll be getting a lot of light here. A lot of these aren't growing too good because of the light. This is the goji berry that I trimmed. Cut the top out of it. Gonna see if it forks up here. I'll probably cut it again. The cherry tomatoes are growing real good. Brad's atomic cherry. I got 2 plants in here. One of them's putting out the pretty ones that you know is supposed to do. They don't taste too bad. They're not as good as the black cherry though. And the other plant is putting out green ones. We haven't tasted these yet, but we'll try them. I'm going to save some seeds to the solid green ones and see if it comes out again like that. I put some pipe work up there. I'm going to be getting ready to put the sunshade screen up here because this area right here will get in a full sun before long. This is another Florida cranberry plant. It hadn't got the sun that it needs, but it will pretty soon. It's still blooming. This is my solar system. Whenever it rains, the rainwater goes into this tank down here that you see, and then every 3 hours the system puts 2 cups of water into each one of these, and it seems to work pretty good. This one right here has the solar hose in it. It's the same plant as this little one here without the solar hose. Just to let you see that this isn't growing as quick as this. There's more fruit on this than there is on this one right here. This is a heat wave, both of them. Just a little experiment trying. We'll keep it going. I'll pull the hose out of one of these down here. Probably going to be changing out a couple of these plants anyway. Some of these plants are supposed to be having big tomatoes on it. They're not big tomatoes, but it's probably because of the lack of sunshine. But they do have a lot of tomatoes growing. And we are not tomato poor anyway. I've probably got over 100 big tomatoes growing right here. These plants right here, they're Abe Lincoln. They're getting real tall, finally putting on some flowers. I know it's because of the lack of the sunlight. I don't know what I'm going to do with these. Probably going to have to pull them out and put something else there. And this last plant right here is a Sweet 100 cherry tomato. It's growing all different directions right now, and it's going to be producing a bunch. And this plant right here, check this out. This is the first bloom with a bean on it. This is the snake bean, Indian Giant. I had a half a dozen seeds. I only got one to come up. So I'm hoping to get some beans on it, get them nice and long to where I got some seeds. It's just a toy. I don't know what they taste like. Hopefully they're good. And then I planted a couple Armenian cucumbers down here. It's not really a cucumber. I do believe you would call it a melon. And they should cook out pretty good. I have to keep my tomatoes that are ripening covered to keep the birds off of it. They're a real nightmare right now. This is a heat master. And like I say, I'm not getting a lot of rain, but or we're not getting any rain right now, but I'm not getting a lot of sun through here yet. Be about another 15-20 days probably before they're got a bunch, and we'll just see what happens. Abe Lincoln, this is a nice sized tomato. But once we get more sun, maybe it'll get us better. This is a bitter melon. I've never grown these or had them. Don't know if it's gonna be any good. It's doing a bunch of male flowers. It hadn't started any females yet that I know of. But we're hoping it goes up here and runs down this way. I'm hoping I get all the plants to go that way, but we'll find out. And let's see. We did some red Malabar spinach. It's got a little bit of light on it right now. And I did some other Egyptian spinach and a red orca, I think it is, spinach. I planted them once and a raccoon got in here and destroyed it, so I had to plant some more. And then I have another zucchini plant growing in here just because. There's my solar panel for this drip feeding system that I have. I've done a video on it to show. It's pretty unique. I'm going to be getting another set up and doing another one pretty soon on this new tomato system that I'm doing. So right now it's kicking. It's really awesome. It's very inexpensive for a hydroponic growing system. Out of all this that I have growing out here, I probably got, wow, less than $500 involved in all of it. I mean, when you look at the buckets, they're under $5 a piece. All these parts are cheap. I'm going to be showing you what all parts you need now. I've got it down cheaper to where I'm doing a six bucket system, something like this right here. Six buckets that I'm going to grow tomatoes in. I made the frame out of 2x4s. It's on a skid system to where you can just pull it on the ground and it not get stuck in. Like I say, these wheels on this, 25 bucks a piece. They hold a lot of weight, but when the ground gets wet or just with the pressure of this system, they bury themselves in the ground, so it's a little bit harder to get it out. The other one won't bury itself down. So that'll be next week. I'll get all the parts in and I'll show you how to do it. And stay tuned for some more updates. This is so impressive. I love it, man. Check this stuff out.